Hey guys, so in this video, we are going over 10 of the top cryptocurrency that you can buy in 2021. In my opinion, we are in the middle of some type of crypto bubble, but that does not mean that there's no opportunity to make money in crypto anymore. So yeah, right now we're gonna go over some of the best and most popular cryptocurrencies that people are buying today. Let's get started. So the first coin we're talking about is Bitcoin. This is the one that almost everyone knows. And there really is no disputing that this is the king of cryptocurrencies. It's the one that I have the most of, and it's the one that I'm gonna continue holding the most of in my portfolio. So right now, Bitcoin is trading at just over $45,000. And if you take a look at the 1 year price chart, we can see that just about 1 year ago, Bitcoin was trading at around $8,000, $9,000, $10,000 per coin. Since then, Bitcoin has grown dramatically. You know, it started out growing pretty slowly at the end of last year, but ever since the beginning of 2021, that's when we really saw the price start to shoot up. So we started the year at just about $29,000 per coin, and right now we are sitting at about $45,000, $46,000 per coin, with an all-time high of just about over $60,000. So in the last 24 hours, Bitcoin is down about $2,500, AKA about 5%. And you can just see how volatile even Bitcoin is, which is the biggest and probably one of the most stable cryptocurrencies, with a 24-hour low of 45.8K and a 24-hour high of just under $50,000. We can see that the 24-hour trading volume is about $55 billion. And when I said that Bitcoin is the king of crypto, I really do mean it. It's being caught up to, but right now it's sitting at about 39.94%. And the market cap is $865 billion, absolutely insane. And if you consider all the possible coins that there are, so aka 21 million possible coins, the market cap at the current prices would leave a market cap of $971 billion. So this grade is a little bit outdated, but as of June 3rd, 2019, they're giving Bitcoin A-, and it gets pretty high scores in all these different categories. So that is always good to see. The Token Insight rating is an AA, and the Dynamic Performance score is 85.51. And then if we take a look at the analysis, this also gives us some really cool information. So we can see the number or percentage of holders making money at the current price. 76% in, 20% out. The concentration by large holders is at 12%. We can look at the holders' composition by time held. So 57% of people are holding it over 1 year, 30% are holding between 1 to 12 months, and 13% are holding under 1 month. So it seems like a lot of people that hold Bitcoin are holding it for quite a long time. If you guys wanna learn a little bit more about Bitcoin, I suggest coming here to coinmarketcap.com. I'll link it in the description below, but you can scroll down here, click read more, and this is gonna give you a really good overview of what Bitcoin is and how it works. Okay, the next coin we're talking about is Ethereum ETH. This is also a very, very popular coin. If you guys have already invested in Bitcoin, then chances are you've also invested in Ethereum, as it's the second biggest coin by market cap. So right now, Ethereum is just under $3,500 a coin. And if you take a look at the price chart for like the last 5 years, you can see just like Bitcoin, it's went up a lot to just about $1,300 a coin. This is back at the beginning of 2018, but then we saw it drop pretty dramatically, just like all cryptos. Since then, it's seen a really big resurgence in price, especially at the start or end of last year. It started really, really going up in price. Starting 2021, we can see it was around $900 per coin. And since then it has, what is that, like 4x'd in price. In the last 24 hours, the price has gone down about $250 a coin. And you can see the 24-hour low is $34.60 and the 24-hour high is $38.78. The 24-hour trading volume is sitting at about $41 billion. And right now the market cap is $403 billion in total. So if you guys don't know what Ethereum is, it's basically a decentralized open source blockchain that features its own cryptocurrency, which is actually called Ether. So I know a lot of people will get this mixed up. Ethereum is the platform and Ether is the actual token. It was created in 2013 by Vitalik Buterin. He's now a billionaire. And the whole goal of Ethereum was to become a global platform for decentralized applications. So it actually has a lot of cool uses that a lot of people aren't aware of. Ethereum has a really good health score at 971. Let's go down here and take a look at some of these reports. So as of February 28th, Symmetry is giving it a B+ grade. It has an A stable outlook, Token Insight rating, and the dynamic performance score is 77. So if you take a look at the number of people that are actually making money at the current price, you can see most people that hold Ethereum are making money, 94%. Doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to make money, but it is a pretty interesting statistic to look at. The concentration by large holders, this is basically if there are people that hold more than 1% of the circulating supply. This is 41%. We don't want this to be too high. And then if we look at the holders composition by time held, we can see that 57% are holding over 1 year, 34% are holding between 1 to 12 months, and 9% are holding under 1 month. So yeah, Ethereum, definitely one of the most popular cryptos out there, and probably one that you've already heard of. I definitely have a significant portion of my crypto portfolio in Ethereum, so I really do believe in this coin. So the next crypto coin we're talking about is Cardano, ADA. So right now Cardano is trading at $2.10. It's down about 7% in the last day. And if we come here, we can take a look at the market cap. So it's sitting at about $67 billion. The trading volume in the last 24 hours is $11 billion. So that volume is actually down quite a bit, 27%. And if you take a look at the price chart, you can see, you know, back in 2018, it hit $1 per coin. Then it really dropped down. That's when a lot of people sold off their coins. And basically it was sitting at around 5 cents for a long time, but starting in the pandemic, that's when it started to go up. We saw it go to about 10 cents. Then we saw it sort of drop back down. And since then, it's just absolutely exploded, especially in the last few weeks. So, okay, it dropped a little bit more as I was filming this video, but right now it's $2.09, down about 8% in the last 24 hours. And according to the market rank, this is number four. So this is the number four highest market cap for cryptocurrencies with a market dominance of 3.2%. Basically what Cardano is it's a proof of stake blockchain platform whose goal is to bring about positive global change. So this is an open source project, and they're basically trying to redistribute power from unaccountable structures to the margins to individuals. And basically just they're trying to create a society that is more secure, transparent, and fair. And they have a health score of 963, so very good. Let's take a look at this report. So as of December 20, 2018, they gave it a grade of C+, and then the Token Insight rating is a BBB. Going to the analysis, we can see that 96% of people that hold Cardano right now have made money. The concentration of large holders is 24%, so that is better than Ethereum. This one is one that a lot of people have not held for a long time, so only 11% of people have held Cardano for over 1 year. Most people, about half, have held between 1 to 12 months, and 37% have held under 1 month. So this really means that a lot of new people are buying in. So there's a lot of new money being injected into this coin. I don't have much Cardano right now, but it is a coin that I'm actively putting on my watch list. And if I do see another buying opportunity for Cardano, I will buy more in the near future. Okay, the next cryptocurrency we're talking about is Stellar. And right now Stellar is trading at about 69 cents per coin. The market cap is about $15.99 billion. Trading volume in the last 24 hours is $4.7 billion. And of the total supply, we are at 40% right now. So that means that there's 54% of coins that have not yet been made. If we take a look at the price chart, you can see back in 2018, it really, really shot in price. It actually hit, I'm not really seeing this exactly, but over 70 cents per coin. So it actually was higher than what the price is right now. And I do remember this because I had a good amount of Stellar back then. It hit a really high price back in 2018, so I was really happy. But then, of course, like all coins, it crashed and saw a lot of fluctuations in price. But yeah, at the start of 2020, you know, it was around 7 cents a coin. And then back at the end of 2020, and then also since the start of 2021, that's when Stellar has really, really gone up in price. So right now, like I said, 69 cents per coin. In the last 24 hours, Stellar is up about 2.9%. The trading volume is also up 21.59%. So that's interesting to see. And then as far as how big this coin is, it's right now ranked number 14 based on the market cap. So Stellar was released in July 2014. And the current goal right now with Stellar is to help financial firms connect with one another through blockchain technology. So the native token is actually called Lumens, and it serves as a bridge that makes it less expensive to trade assets across borders. One really interesting thing about Seller is that transaction costs are just 0.00001 XLM. So really, they were like, we don't want high costs. We want to make payments pretty easy and really affordable. So looking at the ratings, we can see right now Seller has a health score of 909, a grade of C plus as of September 25th, 2020, and a token insight rating of BB. Okay, the next one on my list is Dogecoin. This is the wildly popular meme coin that recently exploded in price. So if we take a look at the price chart, you can see even back in 2018, this coin was sitting at under half a cent, right? So extremely, extremely cheap. It basically stayed around there, went down a little bit. And then in 2021, this is when it like really, really blew up, especially in the recent weeks. So if you look on April 7th, this coin was only 5.9 cents per coin. And right now it's just over 50 cents per coin. So it's almost 10x in price. If we zoom in a little bit closer to the last month, we can see this is a pretty volatile coin, you guys. Around 1 month ago, it was like in the high 30 cents. Area. It dropped back down, went back up to the around 40 cents, went back down to around 20 cents, slowly went back up to the high, which was about 70 cents per coin. And since then, it's really been sort of on a downtrend. I don't really recommend investing in this if you aren't down to experience a lot of volatility. So like I said, the current price is about 51 cents in the last 24 hours. The price is actually up about 3% with a 24-hour low of 49 cents and a 24-hour high of 54.8 cents. The trading volume has actually gone down quite a bit in the last 24 hours. So it's down 25% to about $8 billion. The market dominance is 3.11% and it's actually ranked number 5 in cryptocurrencies based on market cap, which is absolutely insane when you think about how this coin was just made to be a joke. So if you guys don't really know what Dogecoin is, it's basically based on the popular Doge internet meme. And the design is pretty cute. The coin itself has a Shiba Inu on it. This is one of those coins that has been heavily tied to Elon Musk. So whenever he tweets about this coin, the price tends to go up. And yeah, it's just really crazy because we've actually seen a lot of new millionaires being made as a result of this coin. Obviously, since this was made as a joke, the ratings are kind of all over the place. So it has a health score of 881. The Symmetry report lists this as a D grade as of 2019, and the token insight rating is BB. If we take a look at the analysis, we can see that 87% of people that hold Dogecoin have actually made money on it, and 5% of people have lost money on it. One of the really bad things about Dogecoin is that the concentration by large holders is very high at 65%. This means that if there's one person that has a lot of Dogecoin and decides to sell a bunch of it, that's gonna really, you know, affect the market and it could really crash the price. 51% of people have held Dogecoin for over a year, 25% have held between 1 to 12 months, and 24% have held under 1 month. I did buy a bunch of Dogecoin at around 4.5 cents a couple months ago, and I sold that all at about 38 cents, so I made a little profit. But then recently, I did buy back in the high 40s, just for fun. I think this is a fun coin to hold, and I'm not too scared about the volatility, but don't get this coin if you don't like volatility, because you'll be checking the price a lot. You'll be making money some days, losing money some days. It's just not the most fun thing for most people. Okay, the next coin we're talking about is XRP. This is Ripple, and right now Ripple is trading at $1.43 per coin. If we take a look at the price chart, you can see XRP actually hit over $3 a coin back in 2018, then saw a tremendous, tremendous drop in price, selling down around the like 20, 30 cents per coin. We saw a big jump at the end of last year to about, let's see, 60 cents per coin. Then it really corrected back down to about 30 cents a coin. And since then, we saw a really big increase in price. So if we actually zoom into the 1 month price chart, or actually let's try and take a look at the 3 month price chart. We can see that around 3 months ago, it was at about 52 cents per coin. Saw a big jump back in April to a high of about almost $2 per coin. Since then, it's really leveled off and it's sitting around $1.50 per coin. So actually right now it's trading exactly at $1.42. The last day it is up about 0.4%, and the trading volume in the last 24 hours is up 15%. So we're seeing a trading volume of about $12-13 billion. The market dominance is 2.34%, and the market rank is number 7. So XRP was created by Ripple, and the whole point of it was to become a faster and a less costly way to send money. So XRP has a health score of 746, which is a B. The Symmetry report lists it as a D as of December 31st, 2020, and the Token Insight rating is a BBB. Okay, the next coin we're talking about, I think a lot of you guys have not actually heard about this, and it's Thorchain, aka Rune, R-U-N-E. In the last couple years, we saw Rune trading under a dollar for a long, long time, until very recently when it actually broke above a dollar at the end of 2020. And since then, the price has just gone up significantly. If we zoom into actually the 3-month price chart, we can see that we saw a couple corrections, especially here from mid-April down to about $10. So we saw like a 30, 40% correction right there. And since then, the price has gone up to almost $20 a coin. So the current price right now is $19. In the last 24 hours, we saw the price actually go up almost 8% by $1.37. Okay, actually $1.41. The trading volume is up 47%. So a lot more people are buying and selling this coin in the last day. And the trading volume itself is actually $207 million. So this coin is a lot smaller than some of the other ones that we have been talking about. As far as market dominance, it's sitting at 0.21%. So really is quite small with a market rank of 41. So if you guys don't know what Thorchain is, it's basically a decentralized liquidity protocol. And it basically is allowing people, users to exchange crypto from one coin to another coin without really losing custody of their assets in the process. So I do think that Thorchain actually has a lot of cool uses, and that's one reason I like this one. In 2019, it received a grade of a B-, so not bad. And it has a Token Insight rating of B. It's also interesting because Thorchain actually does not have a publicly known CEO or founder. And the whole development of the platform is through GitLab. But I really do like what they're trying to do with this coin, and that's definitely one reason why I think this could be a good coin to buy. Okay, next coin we're talking about is Litecoin, aka LTC. And if we take a look at the price chart, we can see that the current price has just surpassed what the high price was back in 2018. We saw it drop all the way down to about $23 a coin. We did see actually quite a big increase in price at the end of 2018 and the start of 2019. The coin saw a pretty big jump at the start of the pandemic, but since then, like around the end of 2020, that's when the value of Litecoin has really skyrocketed even beyond its old all-time high. So if we take a look at the last 3 months, we can see that it's pretty volatile. You know, we've seen some big dips here and there. For example, it went from about $320 here, April 17th, all the way down to $230 per coin in just one single week. So that is a pretty big correction. And since then, it went up in price a lot, to a high of about $400, and since then it did see a correction. So yeah, very volatile coin. I don't recommend this for people that don't like volatility. So the current price right now is $296.36. The last 24 hours, we saw the price go down about 1.5%. The trading volume per day is about $5 billion, so that is down about 7%. And as far as market dominance, this is at 0.93%, and it's ranked number 12 in terms of market cap. So Litecoin is also one of the more original cryptocurrencies that a lot of people were buying back in the day. And the whole point of Litecoin was to provide fast, secure, and low-cost payments by leveraging the unique properties of blockchain technology. It does have a different hashing algorithm than Bitcoin, but it is based on the whole Bitcoin protocol. And some benefits of Litecoin is that it has a block time of just 2.5 minutes and it has extremely low transaction fees as well. So right now Litecoin has a health score of 793, giving it an A. It received a grade of C back in 2019. And the token insight rating is a BBB. And we take a look at the analysis, we can see that 82% of people that hold Litecoin right now have actually made money, 10% have not. The concentration by large holders is actually pretty high for Litecoin, so that's something that's not as good. It's 51%. And then let's look at the composition of time held. 48% of people have held Litecoin for over 1 year, 28% have held it between 1 and 12 months, and 24% have held under 1 month. All right, the next coin we're talking about is Polkadot, aka Dot, D-O-T. So Polkadot is a relatively new coin, and you can see like at the start of 2021, it was just about, let's say, $8 a coin. And since then, it really has gone up quite a bit. Right now it's in the low $40 per coin. The actual price right now is $41.08, and in the last 24 hours, we've actually seen a pretty big correction of almost 10%. So Polkadot's price is down almost 10%. And also as a result of that, the trading volume is also down a lot. It's down almost 50%. And if we look at the market dominance, we can see it's 1.83% with a market rank of 8. And the total market cap right now is about $38.8 billion. So Polkadot is an open source sharding multi-chain protocol. And the purpose of it is to facilitate the cross-chain transfer of any data or asset types. The protocol connects public and private chains, permissionless networks, oracles, and future technologies. And it allows independent blockchains to actually share information and transactions through the Polkadot relay chain. So Polkadot has a grade of B and it has a token insight rating of BBB. There are currently a total of 1 billion DOT tokens. And yeah, this is just one of those interesting cryptocurrencies that a lot of people are trading in right now. All right, the final cryptocurrency we're talking about today is Chainlink, AKA Link, L-I-N-K. This is also a relatively new coin. We can see it start off under $1 per coin. And since the beginning of last year, the price has really gone up. We did see a pretty big correction starting at the end of last year in 2020. But since then, it's really gone up in price with a few small corrections. And yeah, the current price right now is $39.23. In the last 24 hours, the price is down about 6.5%. The trading volume is also down about 20% in the last 24 hours with a trading volume of $2.1 billion. The market dominance is 0.79% and the market rank is number 13 with a market cap of $16.8 billion. So Chainlink was founded in 2017 and it's basically a blockchain abstraction layer that enables universally connected smart contracts. Chainlink allows blockchains to securely interact with external data feeds, events, and payment methods, providing the critical off-chain information needed by complex smart contracts to become the dominant form of digital agreement. And Chainlink is an Ethereum-based ERC-20 token, and it is secured by proof of stake. Chainlink has a health score of 933, a B grade rating as of 2020, and a token insight rating of BBB. And it's interesting because 86% of people that have held this token have made money and only 9% of people have not made money. One of the bad parts about this token is the concentration by large holders. It's sitting at 79%, which is extremely high. And then let's also take a look at the composition by time held. So it seems like only 14% of people have held this coin for over a year. 71% have held between 1 to 12 months and 15% have held under 1 month. So there you have you guys. Those are 10 of the top cryptocurrencies that you can buy today in 2021. I know I didn't go too much into detail for each of these coins, but I will be making separate, really in-depth guides to a lot of these cryptocurrency tokens. Like I mentioned before, crypto right now is definitely in some type of bubble. I don't know how long this is going to last, but I still do think that you can make money if you buy and sell the right coins. Make sure you guys take this video as entertainment purposes only, as I am not a financial analysis. And before you invest in anything, especially cryptocurrencies, make sure you do your own due diligence. Definitely don't buy any of these coins just because it was on this list. If you are interested in buying any of them, I recommend doing at least 1 hour part of research. Go look at the white paper, go look at the actual website, see if you agree with the whole purpose of the coin. And if everything checks out, then that's when I recommend actually buying a coin. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to my channel to see more videos just like this. I make a ton of content about personal finance, investing, and entrepreneurship. Happy trading, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.